The person will be romancing the road. The person will be walking last in. The person will walk majestically. And as the person is walking, the car is.
It's all I need. There's no one ever say close to me. It's all I need.
Hi guys, welcome back to the channel. If this is your first time stopping by, you're welcome. Please don't forget to click on the subscribe button down below. Okay, after clicking on the subscribe button, do me a favor and also click on the bell notification. This is so you'll be notified whenever I upload new videos. Okay, to all my subscribers, thank you so much. I am honestly grateful for your support on my channel. See, I don't take any of your support for granted. God bless each and every one of you. Okay, welcome to another Vlogmas. Thank you for your support so far. Okay, well, today I'll be talking about transportation, like transportation in Ghana and in Nigeria. Okay, let's start with Nigeria. If you live in Nigeria or if you grew up in Nigeria, places like Lagos, Nigeria, Port Harcourt, Okay, let's start with Lagos. If you live in Lagos or you are still living in Lagos, you can testify. Okay, when you are at a bus stop, you are waiting for a ride, like you're waiting for a bus, DAFO, anything they call it, to come out, like you have a place you're going to and you're waiting for them at the bus stop so that you can enter. See, in Lagos, they don't wait for you. Like the drivers, some of the drivers, in fact, if not all, they cannot match break entirely for you to come down. You know, you say, driver, I'm going to, okay, let's say, oh, shoddy. Then they will not stop. Then you do like this and go. Mm-mm. See, it's a hustle. Like, hey, Jesus. They are not stopping. They are not even stopping. You too, you don't even wait for them to stop before you jump in, because if you are not jumping in, another person is jumping in, and at the end of the day, you will remain at that bus stop, you know, and you miss that particular one. And sometimes, this might be maybe the final bus, or you might not see the particular bus again going to your destination. You have to wait and wait and wait and wait for another one to come out. Okay, then another one, when you are alighting, like when it's time for you to alight, you get to your destination and you want to come down from that bus. See, you've already told them, you've already informed them, see, I'm going down a so-so place. Stop, like match break for you. They will not match break. Like, bam, okay, go down. No, even you, it's also a hustle to go down. If you see people, it's not easy. The way people, you know, jump down from the bus, like, people living in Lagos are used to this lifestyle, I'm telling you. If you see the way people jump down, like, it's so scary. Like, sometimes I wonder, in fact, it's not even about wondering. A lot of people have hurt themselves, like, because of this. Some have, you know, it's not everybody that can just jump in and jump down. Some people on their way on to jumping in, they will hurt themselves. And some people, before coming down, something happens. You know how those bus downfalls are, they are not always smooth at like the step when you are going down. It's not always smooth, something can happen and you just find yourself hot. Okay, coming to Ghana, it's always all the way around. So here, I'm going to, after this, like after talking about this, I'm going to put a video. You watch this video. I took this video myself, like, to show you how the drivers match break, like the match break.
Are you seeing the way they are calmly waiting for their passengers to come? Guys, see what I'm telling you now. This bus is going to wait for me now until I get to that place. They are not moving.
myself, like to show you how the drivers match brake, like the match brake for the passengers to come in. In Ghana here, if you are waiting for your ride, if you are at the bus stop, see, when they match brake and wait for you. The other thing it doesn't, the good part of it, another good part of it is that sometimes the passenger is on the other side of the road and you will see the mate waiting, like the mate stopping the cars coming from every end for her to cross, like for the person to cross, for the passenger to cross. This is to tell you like how it is, like the mate is like a conductor in Nigeria. If you haven't watched the videos about this, I will link it up, maybe you can watch it. The mates are conductors, we call them conductors in Nigeria, they are mates here. So the mate will be the one to even stop the car so that you will cross, you know, you will cross. Some people say, you know, it's like that will be a video, another video. See the way they cross road here, ay Jesus. You will stop, like you will stop. A car will stop for somebody to pass. If you see how the person will be romancing the road. Person will be walking last in. The person will walk majestically. And as the person is walking, the car is not moving. Even if they have thousands of millions of cars, they will all wait for the person to pass. Okay, the driver will match brake and wait. When the person cross the road, they will enter, sit down. Then the driver will move. You don't get it. The driver will match brake, stop. When I mean stop. Then the passenger will enter. This one is not you are entering, one of your legs is outside, you are checking, this one, no. You will enter like you're entering your own personal car, like you're entering your personal car. They will match brake for you. You enter, they close the door. You will relax, and the driver will move. Jesus, life is good. Do you know when it's time for you to alight? You inform them that you are alighting at Soso Junction, Soso bus stop. They will stop again. In fact, this one is even if they have not gotten to a place, maybe a good place, you know, where you can feel comfortable to come down, they will ask you to wait, like wait until they park well, where is much comfortable for you to come down. Then they will park, then you will go down gently. The conductor, the mate will open the door for you. You will go down. Even if they are not waiting for any passenger to come, they will still match this brake and wait for you to go down. Jesus. Honestly, I was so shocked. I was like, wow. You see, there is something about Ghanaians. They are not, you know, living that, okay, that's the word, boss bars lifestyle, like today you are going money, everybody is work, you know. No, they are like jealous, simple, like they believe what you are doing to get them to, they will get it. Like you see people walking majestically, no stress me kind of lifestyle. So this is who they are, like this is who they are, honestly. And if you ask me, honestly, I once told my friend that lives in Lagos, I told her that you people age, like you age very fast, you will grow old very fast because of the lifestyle, Lagos lifestyle. And she said back to say that to you, Abara, but that is the fact. If you are in Lagos, even if you have your private car, it's still not easy. You deal with the traffic. Then if you don't have a car and you have to use the public transport on daily basis, oh Jesus, then that is when you understand life in Lagos. Okay guys, thank you so much for watching this video. Please don't forget to give this video a thumbs up. Did you enjoy it? Do you want more? Please support me. If you haven't subscribed, don't forget to click on the subscribe button down below, okay, so that you will join us here. To all my Ghanaians, it's a ifishapa to all Nigerians, compliment of the season. I don't even know why Nigerians don't have one language, honestly. Like in Ghana, when I say ifishapa, everybody already know what it means, compliment of the season. But in Nigeria, you just have to speak English so that everybody will know. Okay, To all my Ghanaians, Ebishapa, Nigerians, compliment of the season. Thank you so much for supporting my vlogmas. I'll see you again tomorrow. Bye. I love you all.